Hello and good morning to all of you. Today's presentation is the continuation of last presentation on clinical examination of respiratory tract. Myself, Dr. Umesh Kumar Sapra from Postgraduate Department of Rog Nidan, Chaudhary Param Prakash Arvind Sansthan, New Delhi. So as you can see on the slide, examination of every system is always divided into four parts, starting from inspection, palpation, percussion and auscultation. We have already discussed about the inspection part. So now we will proceed to the next slides. Palpation. In palpation, you have to see position of the apex feet and trachea, second chest expansion, symmetry on the both sides, tenderness and vocal parameters. Now you can see in the pictures, tracheal position, it is in the midline and palpated in the suprasternal notch, and apex beat, it is 3.5 inches towards the left side in the fifth intercostal space within the mid clavicular line. So you have to palpate trachea in the suprasternal notch and apex beat in the fifth intercostal space in the mid clavicular line. Now coming to the common causes of tracheal deviation. Towards the side of the lung region, it is found in upper lobe or lung collapse, upper lobe fibrosis, pneumonectomy. Away from the side of the lung region, tension, pneumothorax, massive pleural effusion, upper mediastinal mass, retrosternal goiter, lung cancer and lymphoma. Now coming to the chest expansion, most of important feature is, as you can see in the picture, we have to see the chest expansion and it should be symmetrical bilateral. Patient has to take deep breath. Again, you have to see the movement of the fingers on the both sides. It should be symmetrical on the both sides. Normal expansion is 5 cm. But if it is less than 1 cm, that may be the case of severe emphysema. Other causes of reduced chest expansion may be related with just like lung collapse and pneumonia. As you can see in the right hand side of the picture, this expansion should be seen both on the anterior as well as posterior side, and the expansion should be symmetrical on the both sides. Now coming to the causes, general restriction of expansion may be in COPD, extensive bilateral disease, ankylosing spondylitis. Asymmetrical expansion may be in pleural effusion, pneumothorax, consolidation, collapse and fibrosis. Now coming to the tenderness. Tenderness may be found in empyema, means pus in the lung cavity. Local inflammation of parietal pleura or soft tissue, infiltration with tumor, or sometimes non-respiratory causes just like amoebic liver abscess. Now coming to the vocal parameters. Vocal parameters means you have to put your hand on the surface of the lungs and feel the sounds of the respiratory tract from the patient's volume. Just like patient speaks 99, 9, and you have to feel the vibrations. So vocal parameters is the vibrations detected by palpation with the palm of the hand on the chest. When the patient is asked to repeat 99 or 111, and should be seen, okay, like low pitch, mid pitch and high pitch on the lower, mid and upper part of the posterior side of the chest. So it is increased in consolidation and decreased in pleural effusion. Now coming to the percussion, as you can see in the picture, it is a tapping method on the surface of to determine the underlying structure. As you know, okay, lungs, so it should be resonant in sound. Position of the patient, it should be sitting posture, which is the best. Supine position is not desirable because of the alteration by underlying structures. And the areas of the chest percussion, from A, B and C, you can see in posterior, anterior as well as lateral views. So you have to percuss in the zigzag pattern, Z pattern, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. ठीक है, पोस्टीरियरली इन द ए पिक्चर एंड देन बी देन सी लेटरली, सो परकशन विल बी देयर, शुड बी डन. नाउ परकशन नोट मोस्टली इन हेल्दी लंग्स इट इज रेजोनेंट, हाइपर रेजोनेंट व्हेन नेवर देयर इज टू मच एयर, जस्ट लाइक इन निमोथेरेक्स और एम्फाइसीमा. डल साउंड व्हेन नेवर देयर इज एबनॉर्मल लंग डेंसिटी, निमोनिया, प्लूरल इफ्यूजन, स्टोनी डल, प्लूरल इफ्यूजन और हीमोथेरेक्स. कमिंग टू द ऑस्कल्टेशन, ठीक है, एज यू नो, ठीक है, नाउ वी आर यूजिंग द स्टेथोस्कोप टू हियर द साउंड्स. सो दीज थिंग्स शुड बी कीप्ट इन माइंड. आर द ब्रेथ साउंड इंक्रीज, नॉर्मल और डिक्रीज, आर दीज एबनॉर्मल और एडवेंटेजियस ब्रेथ साउंड्स. सो दीज आर द एरियाज, इंटीरियर व्यू एंड पोस्टीरियर व्यू. सो यू हैव टू सी ऑन द both sides of the chest, right and left, and compare the sound. Posteriorly also you have to check in the zigzag pattern, Z pattern, and then compare on the both sides of the lungs. Now you have to see type of breath sound, whether there is any adventitious sound, vocal resonance, and any other miscellaneous sounds present in the lungs. Now coming to the normal chest sound. As you know, there are different kinds of chest sound, bronchial, vesicular and bronchovesicular. Bronchial sound, it is related with the trachea. It is a high pitch, louder inspiration and expiration are equal. And there is a pause between inspiration and expiration. You can remember bronchial by B. B means break. So there will be a pause between inspiration and expiration. And as it is a higher pitch, louder inspiration and expiration are equal. Now coming to the vesicular sound, it is heard over the thorax. It is low pitched and softer than the bronchial breathing. Now coming to the types, as I have discussed, vesicular, bronchial and bronchovesicular. Vesicular is over most area of the chest, bronchial is in the trachea and larynx. Bronchovesicular over and around the upper part of sternum. Now coming to the adventitious sounds, wheezing, whistle-like sound. It is a continuous musical sound on expiration or inspiration. A wheeze is the result of narrowed airways. Common causes may be include asthma and emphysema. So in asthma, the expiratory wheeze is present. It is just like a whistle-like. Musical sound. Now coming to the ronchi, it is an increasingly obsolete term. Now this term is basically not used. Most of the author now are saying that wheezing and ronchi are almost the same, but it is having low pitched musical bubbly sound heard on inspiration and expiration. It is the result of viscous fluid in the airways. Mostly now we are using the terms wheezing. So there are abnormal sounds just like wheezes, crepitations. These are the commonly used nowadays. Crackles, okay, or rails, okay, crackles are just like crackling sounds, okay, when you rub the dry hairs. Karkad like awaaz, intermittent non-musical and brief sound heard during inspiration only. They may be described as fine, soft, high pitched or coarse. Louder or low pitch. These are the result of alveoli opening due to increased air pressure during the inspiration. Common causes include CCL, congestive body failure. Stridor, it is a high pitched musical breath sound resulting from turbulent airflow in the larynx or lower in the bronchial tree. Causes include obstructive, just like foreign body, epiglottitis, tumor and anaphylaxis. Now coming to the vocal resonance. Vocal resonance is the just like where there are various types, bronchophony, egophony, whispering, pectoraliqui. Vocal resonance is increasing just like consolidation. Voice sounds are louder and more distinct, reduced in effusion as well as collapse. Now coming to egophony, it is an increased resonance of voice sound heard when auscultating the lungs, often caused by lung consolidation and fibrosis. Now other miscellaneous sounds, just like pleural rub and pleuropericardial rub. Pleural rub is found just like in cases of pleurisy. It is always associated with pain. It is a superficial localized or grating sound. Pleuropericardial rub is present in pleurisy adjacent to the pericardium. Thank you. So we have discussed today related with the palpation, percussion as well as auscultation. So most important take home message is that always try to auscultate the patient and hear the normal as well as abnormal sound. Abnormal sound may be bronchial, vesicular or bronchovesicular, whereas abnormal breath sounds may be either ronchi or wheezing, sometimes pleural rub or pericardial, pleuropericardial rub may be there. So you should always try to go for the examination of the patient of the respiratory tract. Thank you very much for the patient hearing for this lecture.